Today's the 28th day of the third month on our Maker's Restored calendar. It's the 10th smooth stone anniversary of when he spit his sign of the dove, aka his sign of Jonah, out from the belly of the great ocean traversing plane against my desire with his restored calendar into the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel, aka Nineveh, aka America. All quite remarkable because this day falls on 428 on his servant Satan's calendar with, according to his great Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir, and 428 is his Feast of Sevens. And how that ties into the doves with the 7 days apart is amazing. Recently, I've spoke about how on 11-11 on our Maker's Restored calendar, when he caused his servant Noah to let loose the dove, the first stroke, plus 490 days, the 490 days of Daniel chapter 9, Daniel chapter 9, took us to 321. And that was amazing because the 49 sevenths of that Daniel chapter 9 prophecy took us to 1230, which is significant, but I'm not going to get into it. But plus the 434 sevenths of the pathway of holiness being built up in troublous times, it says the wall, but that's a mistranslation. But took us to 314 plus the final seven took us to 321. And then you have the second dove waypoint. The second dove, when he caused his servant Noah let loose the dove, the second stroke, plus 490 takes us to today. And that 490 per Daniel chapter 9 breaks down to the seven sevens, which takes us to 107, which is the day that he gives to us in his end time son of Adam prophecies for his end time son of Adam cleansing his house, his sanctuary. 107. It's also the day that the three Nazarites offer up the head of their separation upon the altar that he rose up, the boulder design of his house, per those Ezekiel chapter 40 chapters 40 through chapters 48, those nine chapters. But anyway, so 107, and then you add the 434 sevens, the 62 sevens of 434 days, and it took us to 321, which is the 490th day of the first dove, 7 days. But it parallels the 321 prison mattress, me being in prison. Plus the final 7 days takes us to today, the 490th day. And that's remarkable, and I'll get to the third dove tier here as we move on. But that's just remarkable where we're at today, because we're on the 434th day, well, the 483rd day of the of the third dove, the 490 that goes from the third dove on 11/25 plus seven. So that's just remarkable, but because where we're at and what he's doing with drawing out his dual nostrils. So when I say 483rd, I'm talking about the 49 days of the seven sevens and the 434 days of the 62 sevens. That's 483 sevens plus 7 days is 490. So today's the 434th day, but just remarkable with the second dove. He spoke the 10 words out to our ancestors out from the thick dark cloud and the thunderings and the lightnings on 318. Well, 11:18, when his servant Noah, and you could figure out 11:18 for yourself. All you know, you know is 10:1. Is the heads of the mountains were seen, and then he waited 40 days. That's 11:11 on his restored calendar. There's always 30 days in a month, plus 7 days is 11:18. Plus seven is 11:25. It's not complicated, so it isn't rocket scientists. But 11:18 on his restored calendar, meaning the 18th day of the 11th month, is day number 318. For the dove, and he spoke the 10 words, and here we got these 10 years of him sending me to you with his restored calendar, his sign of the dove. It's just truly, truly remarkable. But anyhow, the day number 64 of the year, and 64 is 8/8, or no, day number 64 of the war, was started on the 490th Silver Trump Assembly, day number one. So it's day number 64 of the war today, and that's 8/8, and 3/28 today, the 490th day from the second dove, is day number 88. 3/28 is day number 88 on his restored calendar. 60 days for the first month, 30 days for the first month, 30 days for the second, that's 60 plus 28, day number 88. It's not complicated, which is just remarkable, because it's also the eighth day, because that the blood prevailed in it was the 7 days were fulfilled yesterday of the blood in the Nile. The rivers and the waters turned into blood in Egypt. The first plague. The 7 days were fulfilled. Today's the eighth day. A woman with her issue of blood is unclean for 7 days. In the eighth day, she offers up the two doves or the two pigeons that she's clean. So two doves, two different types of doves. But anyway, and she's clean on the eighth day. And other statutes were clean on the eighth day. A man child's circumcised on the eighth day and such. He puts a lot of emphasis on the eighth day. But today's the eighth day, the purifying day. But it's also the day that he caused his servant Moses to appear back before Pharaoh's faces. And he sent the second plague, which is the frogs, which I think I'm getting there to it. But on the eighth day, he sent the frogs when the 7 days were fulfilled yesterday. Per Exodus chapter 7:25. So here we got the eighth day on day number 64, 8/8, and day number 88 of the year. So the frogs are what parallel the three unclean spirits that John saw in the Revelations chapter 16, verse 13, of the three unclean spirits like frogs coming out of the mouth of the dragon and the beast and the false prophet. So anyway, he says these are the spirits of demons. Just wind is kind of strong today, but it's coming at me from that way, which is good, so the tree's blocking most of it. But three unclean spirits like frogs, and he says they're the spirits of demons that bring forth signs, all the signs, and signs of the times that Yeshua talked about in Matthew chapter 24 and stuff, the wars and rumors of war and stuff. See, you be not troubled and such. These things have to be. But bring forth signs that go forth to the kings and all this stuff. I mean, you look at Putin yesterday. I mean, he's sitting there saying, oh, well, the United States is helping them build a nuclear weapon, and he's just digging for reasons to use his tactical nuclear weapons, and everything's going to continue to disintegrate from here, because it's the end war that will desolate, according to Daniel chapter 9. So he bring forth signs that go forth to the kings of the earth, to all of the earth, to gather them to the battle of the great day of El Shaddai, the Almighty Elohim. Well, we're in the 168 days of the great day now, and then followed by the hour, and it brings forth these first four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed. But that's not the purpose of this video. I'll talk about that more in other videos. But anyway, the spirit, the first unclean spirit, like frog, is a spirit of lying against the truth, saying his word says something it doesn't say. That's just what it is. And you say, well, how's that gathering the kings? Well, that's where all the rebellion comes from and everything, but it's lying against the truth. And the second spirit is the spirit of rebellion to the testimony of Yahweh's word. That's just why the world's in the state that it's in. If the world lived in obedience to his word, this wouldn't happen. But it starts with the lying against the truth. And then the rebellion follows. And then the spirit of blaspheming his seven spirits and that which they testify to, which they testify to his righteousness and his truth, to his word. But they testify to his righteous character, to who Elohim is. So it's blaspheming who Yahweh is, saying that he just loves you in spite of your rebellion to him. You're good to go with him. All you got to do is just say, as Saul said, is say his only begotten son died on the stake and that his father raised him from the dead. Well, that's what Saul said. Well, even the demons believe that. But you don't even do that. Most of you say he is his father. Therefore, you say he raised himself from the dead. It's a joke. Your beliefs are a joke. You're saved by grace apart from the works of his straight and narrow pathway that the signature ring, Isaiah 55 signature ring, that teaches us to become as he is. So our thoughts will be like his thoughts, and his word that comes down from the dual heavens to nourish us. So our thoughts will become like his thoughts, and our pathways would be as his pathways are, righteousness. But the third spirit is the spirit of blaspheming against his seven spirits that flow out from the mouth of his two sons, of his Zechariah 4:14 holy anointing oil, to testify to his righteous character. Anyway, so 11:25, when he caused his servant Noah to let loose the dove, the third stroke, which is day number 325 of the year, paralleling the 325 wax hot way point that we just passed 3 days ago, plus 490 is 405, the first seven chapters of his End Time Son of Adam prophecies. And chapter 7 says the end has come. And that includes me going to Tel Aviv. It takes us the 7 days, the 7 hours to the nanosecond. Anyway, I've talked about that in recent videos. But 405 is a remarkable waypoint in this. Day number 95, which he brought us to And the first video was produced on 9/5 on his restored calendar. It's 12/12/2010. Well, that's when it first was uploaded on the Repairing the Breach website. And it's turning the waters into blood. And the water baptism is symbolic of the blood, is the name of that. But of the 11/25, the first seven sevens, or the first 49 days, takes us to 1/14 of 6002. But that's his Passover, his Exodus. Well, that was the Elim Passover, which Elim means, I'm not going to even think about it because I have there, but I should know here, but I can't think it comes from the word ram, but that's a bad one. But I've got too much on my mind. It's an easy one, too. I can think of it. But that's where the 70 palm trees and the 12 eyes of waters were. But that's amazing because his Passover standing before your faces. His backup Passover, you will, the second month, but he's merged Yeshua dwelling in me, and therefore Yeshua standing before your faces. And that's who you left in the wilderness. You left both his sons of his holy anointing oil and the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual-winged great vulture with the four offspring, the first four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed in her belly. That's going to really set well with you, except for three of you that aren't stealing from Gateway. But plus the 434 days of the 62 sevens of the highway being built up takes us to today's sign of the dove waypoint from the third dove. Wow. Plus 7 days takes us to 405, of course. And 70 days prior to today was 118, the resurrection waypoint for the Passover. The resurrection waypoint is 117, but it's at 3 a.m. in the morning. So the dawning of the day is actually when Yeshua appeared to Mary. It was on the dawning of the day on 118. And that ties into Psalms 118, those three strokes of me circumcising you. Prophecy says I'm not going to die. You're going to gather around me like bees do, because the milk and the honey that flows out from me too, the unleavened bread of life. You put a little honey on it. His testimony of his word, because it is sweet. And of course, the book is bitter to the belly as well, because you continue to live in rebellion to him, to the taste. And he's continued to shorten the days by afflicting me in your stead. Even as we speak, which it's what it is, but you're going to find out the joke's on you. Anyway, clearly, I talked about Isaac yesterday. Isaac means laughter or to mock, and Yahweh's getting ready to mock you. You mock me in the day of I'll mock you in the day of your calamity, he says. But the joke's on you. But Isaac was born on 9/10. He gave that last Sabbath on 3/22. But clearly, when we're reading, but he clearly gave it to me that Isaac was born on 9/10, and he's already shown that the first four offspring, he's delayed it over and over again, but the first four offspring will be born on 9/10 on his restored calendar, which is 10/7 on Satan's calendar, which is the day on Satan's calendar that he brought Putin into the world, which is a big part of this. But today plus 162 days is that waypoint. 162 days, 5 days and 12 months. As a matter of fact, I just thought of something. Today is 9,512 days after the grapes of wrath, which is the subject of this video that I'm getting to. So 9,512 days after the beginning of Operation Grapes of Wrath. So 162 days is 5 months and 12 days. That's a neat parallel. But Gateway's getting ready to mock you. So Isaac could basically say, Isaac is symbolic of Meher Shalal Kushbaz, if you will. His Papa Dove that's standing before your faces. But it's just really because Abraham's symbolic of me too. His old word's written upon me. I can't help that. It is what it is. But today on this sign of the dove waypoint, 10 smooth stones later, 3,600 days for Isaac. Isaac was 36 days when Yahweh caused his servant Abraham to be willing to offer him up, and he provided the substitution ram. And he said, provide the substitution of me being afflicted in your stead, just like he set up the substitution through his only begotten son. But the wife fled into the wilderness from that corner lot 60 on 9/18. Plus 910 days is today. But you say, wait a minute, the wife needs to be fled for 1,260 days. Well, when the younger Shulamite gave up her crown on 3/11, there's 1,260 days encompassing that day when she left to go back into Egypt, and the 1,260th day, which is 9/10. But anyway, it's 910 days from when she fled in the wilderness. I thought that was a nice touch on this side of the dove waypoint, 10 years later. But last night was the 155th Powerball, 287th draw, but means tonight, tomorrow night's is 288th draw for the three sets of pomegranates, of 96 pomegranates on those four rows, those two rows on each of Yakin and Boaz, those two pillars, And the three of the four rows of pomegranate of 96 on each one, every Narzan broke them down, but they represent the three man childs, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, and the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zachariah, there in the womb. But last night he caused the 36 for these 36 days in Isaac's 36 years, when Abraham was 136, when he was willing to offer up his only begotten son of his wife Sarah's womb. But I said last night was night number 660 of the shofars, and I talked about in yesterday's video, plus 6 days will take us to 666, which is huge, which is 403. But that's not the subject of this video, but yesterday's URL to show his almighty hand had two numbers in it, 06, zero, six together. I think they're together. Esteemed, as of the start of the recording of this video, at least it hadn't been posted yet, at least at the start of this video, Steamboat number 153 has not blown yet, symbolic of the 153 great fish that those seven disciples pulled to shore that day when Yeshua appeared to them the third time after his resurrection on 118. And not counting when he appeared to Mary, but he appeared to his disciples the third stroke. And they pulled in those 153 great fish. So symbolic of the 153 first fruits that were still alive on July 19th, 2012, on the 428 first fruit harvest, his first restored feast of first fruits on 428. And today's 428 on Satan's calendar. But Ahaziah sent three sets of 50 and one men, 153 men, to bring back my predecessor Elijah to come down off that mountain. So whenever Steamboat 153 blows, I'm confident Cape Way is going to be telling me to come down off that mountain. So we'll keep keeping my finger on the pulse, if you will, of Steamboat. But then Elijah, after those three sets of 51 men, he went with the third set of 51 because they were a little more. The captain was more humble and said, "Listen, I know what you did to the first two, the first 102. Just please come with us." And Gateway said, "Go with them." And he told Ahaziah face to face he was going to die. And I'm getting ready to not talk through this camera. Of course, I'll be talking faces to faces. But that you're going to die. But then Elijah went to cross the Jordan to get taken by the whirlwind, which I thought about naming this video the whirlwind of Elijah or something like that. But anyway, they're crossing the Jordan, and first him and Elisha, his replacement, went to Bethel, the house of Elohim, and of course it was involved with 50 men as well, and the sons of the prophets. And then they went to Jericho, the stitch of a month, your stitches of a month, or you're profaning his appointed times that he sent me to restore, his sign of the dove, all goes together. And then they went to the Jordan. Well, it's interesting because at the Jordan, when he crossed the Jordan, Strong's number 155 is mantle. And last night was the 155th Powerball drawing. And 155 is mantle. He cast his mantle to Elisha, his replacement, and the 155th draw. Well, last night after the draw, he caused me to have a vision, but a vision of Elijah's whirlwind, I guess you will, because Elijah was removed from the scene with the whirlwind and the chariot of fire, and he was chariot of fire and such with the horses and such, and all ties into the symbolism. But he cast his mantle to Elisha, actually when Elisha was plowing with 24 oxen before, but he cast it to him again because his mantle dropped. And Elisha picked it up, and he smote the Jordan River, and it dried up again. And he crossed over himself because he had a double spirit of Elisha given to him in association with that 155 for mantle. And last night's 155th draw, and this vision that I'm getting ready to tell you that he gave me last night. There were two whirlwinds in the vision, two tornadoes, if you will, but they were definitely tornadoes. But going from east to west. But the first one, I was in a residential area, and the first one, I was in my old high school car, my second car, actually. But I was in it, and I crawled on the floor because I could hear it coming, and it was pouring down rain. And yesterday, shut off the rain, 3:27 at 3 a.m. And this vision was approximately hour and 34 minutes after that, because after 3 a.m. when he shut off the rain, but it's pouring down rain. And yesterday, my Yipway took out my umbrella that I used to record the videos because I have to be out in the sun to get a good enough reception, not to record them, to upload them. I have to be out in the sun, so I stand there with an umbrella, and the heavy winds, or whirlwind, I don't know because there's whirlwinds mixed in, but took out my umbrella. So I've been trying to make it do, but it finally yesterday I broke down and took the wife that's fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great vulture to bring forth the man-child and his three siblings. I borrowed her umbrella and brought it out with me. And it got ripped out of my hands. I didn't know I had a 50-yard dash. I didn't know I could run that fast. I really didn't. But I caught it with Gateway's help. But anyway, quite the scene. Watch this fat old guy running through the wilderness, I'm sure, dressed in white, chasing after an umbrella. But anyway, he ripped it out of my hand when I was doing the upload. So I don't know if that was a whirlwind or not. But anyway, but it has drops of rain on it, her umbrella does. So it has drops of rain. Anyway, but it was pouring down rain, and I heard the tornado coming, and I know what a tornado sounds like because I've been around them. But anyway, I crawled on the floorboard. The vehicle was too late to get out, but it was like I couldn't. I pulled over because it was so the rain was so heavy. It was just pouring. I never see anything like it. So anyway, then the rain stops. The tornado went overhead, and they're heading west from east to west, and the rain stopped, and was sitting there, and I think my little brother was there, but I was standing there, and just talking, and all of a sudden, another tornado came by. It was clear skies all of a sudden. The tornado came ripping through to the south of us, still heading east to west, and it was a couple blocks, I would say, and it just came, two and a half blocks came just ripping to the west, south of us, definitely south. So I thought that was amazing. Especially with the great rain, with yesterday shutting off the rains on 327. But anyway, so the with the second one to the south reminded me, got me thinking about the whirlwinds to the south. So Isaiah 21:1, verse 1 of chapter 21, he talks about the whirlwind to the south in relation to the fall of Babylon. Referring to the mother whore, the Roman Catholic whorehouse, and her daughter whores, the religion of Christianity, the fall of mystery Babylon. But her daughters, the Christianity's mother whore's daughters. But anyway, the fall of Babylon with the whirlwind to the south, whirlwinds in the south. And also in Zechariah 9:14, he talks about whirlwinds of the south, which gateway blowing the shofar. And that shofar is with the wine and the oil that I can't get shipped up here on account of you stealing to our maker, but it's stuck there in storage. So that is shofar, but with him blowing that new shofar, the dual shofars I've talked about in recent videos. But anyway, Elohim is blowing the shofars, and with his arrow will go forth like lightning. And yesterday I talked about a lot of different prophecies. I made mention of a lot of different prophecies talking about his arrows with lightning. And talking about these thunders are seven consecutive draws, and they're going to, like lightning, because the thunders accompany lightning. And these seven arrows, and these draws refer to as arrows, which I've done for a long time back, going back to the three arrows of associated with the head of the month, which we're here now for the head of the month of Jonathan. And but he came to, Jonathan shot the first arrow, the only arrow. He only shot one of the three, but on the second day of the month. And of course, the second day of the month, we have two draws before then. We have tomorrow night and Saturn's day night, and then we have the day of the sun is the head of the month, first day of the fourth month, and then 402 would be the third of these draws at this point. But he shot the one arrow, and he shot it for David to know that David wasn't safe for him to go yet. Well, the arrows are going to signify that it is safe for me to go, because it's going to accompany the 153rd steamboat eruption. So, but his arrow will go forth like lightning. So that's one of the places. He uses it in other places too. Refers to his arrows as being lightning. Tying into the thunders, tying into these tickets that I've talked about. It is what it is. But last night, there was a winner in Arizona of all things. Coincidence, the Gateway's anointed's in Arizona, huh? 473.1 zillion was the jackpot amount. Truly amazing. A to Z, for Arizona's abbreviated AZ for A to Z, from Adam to Zerubbabel, from Abel to Zechariah, and on and on and on. There's tons of A to Z references in his word. And Z isn't even the last letter of the Hebrew language, but Gateway orchestrated that by design. But I was then traveling north on the dream vision switched, and same vision though, and all of a sudden I'm in a different scene, and I'm going in between two mountains in a mountain passage on the mountain, and there's a river run through it, the Jordan. I'm symbolic of the Jordan there's two roads, and it ain't that there's one going north and one's going south, because you go both ways on it, at least in the vision, but it's dirt roads anyway, but it's mountain pass, but there just happened to be a road on the other side. So I'm heading north, and I get to the county line or state line or something, and I had two red cans. And I assume they were solid red. I assume it must have been beer. I don't know. I really haven't drank beer in an awful long time. I don't know what was in them. But two red cans. Maybe they were wine, but they were cans. Because I crushed one. Because I sat there and drank one of them. And I sat there because I couldn't cross the state line for some reason. I didn't know. So I just crushed it. And then as I was sitting there, as I finished drinking and sitting there, I maybe was not quite finished drinking. I don't know. But here come Bill Gates and a woman on the other side of the river. And they drive by in this old rusty vehicle. Matter of fact, he didn't even have a door on his driver's side door. Total, it was just rust, a rust bucket vehicle with doors missing, windows missing. And he drives by to the going south, and he yells, you know, he yells, "Have you seen any Splendor?" Well, Splendor is what I call elk. And I had seen one as I traveled north. I said, "Yeah, I seen one." And he kept on going. So anyway, I decided I'd turn right back around and go back to south. I don't know, maybe I'd go see if I see that Splendor again. So I turned back around, and I call him Splendors because the testimony of his word calls him Splendors. So when you look it up. So I turned around and headed back south again. And as I was driving in the south, there was this great big boulder in the road. And it was a whirlwind, but it was a stone. It was a stone whirlwind boulder, I mean, perfectly shaped like a tornado. Totally detailed stone, massive piece of work, with an umbrella on the top of it. And I hold the umbrella on top of the phone when I upload the videos. You gotta be kidding me. The whirlwind, Elijah, has come. It's just time for me to be removed. It's tying in the 153 steamboat, which has been huge all the way alone in this, with the steamboat mattress and everything, tying in the prison mattress and Elijah vision on 521, which I'll get to that too. But anyway, so I'm getting down my notes here. I've been going along and finding out where I'm at. I finished the can, turned around, heading south, huge stone with the umbrella. But I laid there and meditated on the dream for a little bit, a few minutes, as I normally do. And then I got up and to go to the restroom. And the we don't have a bathroom. It's a pickle jar in the tent I pee in. But I go in to go in. It saves the zipper going in and out of the tent all the time. But in the wintertime, it's cold going out of the tent. But anyway, if you ever go camping, it's a good resource. I suggest you make sure you bring a pickle jar. So anyway... So, I estimate it'd be at 4:34 a.m. for the 4:34 sevenths, but it might have been 4:33, which is what I'm getting ready to tell you. But it's still on 3:27, day shut off the rain. Matter of fact, it had been an hour and 34 minutes after, if it's 4:34, it had been an hour and 34 minutes after he shut off the rain, which ties into Psalms 134, which is the 15th step. But tomorrow night is Mega Millions number 133 for the 14th step, 14 and 15. And tomorrow night's draw is 43Z, tying in those 43 races of that short-legged, well, not short-legged, but compared to other horses of her caliber, Australian racehorse that ran those 43 races with 33 wins, superstar back then, but she's retired for a broodmare now. But I liken her to the wife that's fled in the wilderness because she's shorter compared to her caliber of racehorses. And Gateway's Ward likened it to it as well. I mean, other things too. Day number 43 is 213. Day number 213 is 803, which was the cradle stone anointing. And there's just tons of stuff. But anyway, the 43 zillion, she actually has a seven, that racehorse. Winx is her name. Like to win, win X. X marks the spot. But she has a seven on her front left shoulder. I don't know if it's a scar or a brand, but it's a seven in the picture. It's quite remarkable for these 7 days, for the side of the dove and everything else. And these 7 days that we're in now, because tomorrow will be day number, today's the 409th day, tomorrow will be day number one of 7 days, and tomorrow's draw is 43Z, because day's 490, that's correct. Tomorrow will be day number one of, that might answer my question coming up. But anyway, so tomorrow's Sabbath number 322, last Sabbath was on 322, and that was the Hurricane Michael waypoint plus 1290 days, the 1290 days parallel of Daniel chapter 12, and 12 tie of the 1290 is 129, which was the 1260th day that the manual man child Maher Shalal Kush Bezalel was going to be born, according to the sign of the virgin in the sky sign of the virgin's new heaven sign of Revelation chapter 11. And Abraham was born on 129, and Isaac was born on 910, so there was actually I figured it out. How many days? Let's see, we'd be eight months is 240. Wait, no, 129 would be 7 months to 829, 210, and 11 days, 711. That has significance too. For 77 for lots of things, but also for ties in these tickets. But I'm not gonna get into that. But one man knows how. But the anyway, I'll just tell you, because they purchased that 7-Eleven. I'll just tell you, the tickets are so your mind don't wonder. I guess I can tell you that lots of 7-Elevens in the store in the country. So anyway, and a matter of fact, he saw a rainbow over it when he at the same store one time, and the pot of gold's at the bottom of the rainbow. So anyway, a lot of symbolism there. But Hurricane Michael plus 1290 was that last Sabbath, which is 322, and now we have Sabbath number 322 from the 1200. And 60th day of his restored calendar. It's the 322nd Sabbath from the 1260th day of his restored calendar. His sign of the dove with his restored calendar. So moving along, lots of details. I'm just skimming along them. But yesterday's video was 41 minutes and 10 seconds on YouTube. I recorded it was 41.9, but when I uploaded it was 41.10. A tithe of 4,110, of course, is 4.11. The lowest two numbers drawn last night with that Arizona winner, lowest two numbers drawn were 4 and 11. Wow. Operation Grapes of Wrath, 1996, 4-11 on Satan's calendar, 1996 began the 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath. So you're probably thinking, well, did you win or not? Why don't you just tell us? 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath. Well, no, he sent a 16th reduction last night. And you say, well, you didn't think that was going to be. No, I didn't, but I realize it's a possibility. And as scary as it be, I realize the 17 shekels could even play into it with the 17 reduction, but I don't think so. I haven't thought it all along, but that he's going to keep doing this, because the symbolism he wove into last night hitting is amazing, but he keeps afflicting me in your stead. Because Steamboat, if you looked at the Steamboat notes yesterday, it had to blow, but it didn't blow. But I mean, it just... It's just remarkable how he keeps afflicting me in your stead, or afflicting us in your stead, because we're just about out of supplies and certainly just about out of waters. And but the 16th reduction, but to show his almighty hand, yesterday's video, 41.10, for a tithe of that is 4.11, two lowest numbers drawn, 4 and 11, Operation Grapes of Wrath, he sent on 4.11, it was a 16-day operation, gets the White Mountain, and he refers to his holy mountain as the White Mountain in this, Lebanon. The White Mountain, where Israel warred those 16 days against Lebanon, the White Mountain. In scriptures, it means White Mountain. 16th reduction. If that ain't his almighty hand, what is? With the winner in Arizona, his anointed's in Arizona. And that ain't the first winner in these 16 reductions in Arizona either. I think it's only his second, though, but that one was pretty key, too. But anyway, with the five-ball total he called last night was 238, showing his almighty hand, because it means give ear, like give ear to the dual heavens and earth, because they're getting ready to testify. Give ear to these lotteries. Getting ready to testify. Give ear to Steamboat, because it's getting ready to testify. But 238, five ball total. Six ball total is 242. Well, day number 242 on our Maker's restored calendar is 902. He brought the wife that's fled in the wilderness in the world on 902 on Satan's calendar on the Meher Shalal Kush Bazmir. Strong's number, to prove that the symbolism is there for the 242, Strong's number 242 is just used one place. And it means give ear to the near kinswoman, which is what he's been telling you to do. Look at her. She stood with Yahweh's anointed through thick and thin. Even whenever Yahweh took her daughter from her and her husband from her and to bring forth these children, she stood with Yahweh's anointed. remarkable. And he says, give ear to her. Do as she's done. Because his word has a lot to say about standing with his anointed. This is why, part of the reason why he drew it all up this way. And also to show you that you're children of incest. You're children of, and of course, Psalms 45 says that she's going to be brought into the king, but she's not the daughter of the king is going to be brought into her, but it's not the king's daughter. As a matter of fact, tells her to forget her father's house, but she went back to her father's house. And she started the 1260-day clock, which ends on 9:10. It's just reality. But the first three balls that he caused to be drawn last night were, I don't know the order per accident, but they were 61, 62, and 68 for stone. 61 for Abraham. After Abraham lived, Abraham from 75 when he left to 61 years later, he offered up Isaac when he was 36, when 36 was drawn too. But the first three numbers were 61, 62, and 68, not in that order. But they total up to 191 for the highway up out of St. John's to his Holy Mountain, Highway 191 for the Exodus. And plus, to boot that, he doubled it. It was up 19-1 over their 454 estimated jackpot. 19-1 for 191 for the highway. It was higher than the original 454. The previous draw plus 52.1. That's amazing. Is 521. 52.1 zillion was the previous draw plus 52.1 was that 473.1 jackpot last night for the Elijah Dream. Wow, I just had another Elijah Dream last night, didn't I? Whirlwind on 327, days shut off the rain. 43 zillion plus 20 z reset is 63. Didn't I talk about 63 yesterday? You can't see, he does this with every video, and I haven't even looked at the numbers yet last night besides the superficial look I'm talking about in this video. I haven't done the calculations yet, but because I needed to do the notes and get out here, but hopefully before the wind picked up, and I think it's doing pretty good because had some gusts, but overall it's been pretty small compared to what it's supposed to be. 43Z plus 20 is 63. How many times yesterday I talked about the emphasis of 63 with the 63 in these videos? How many times I talked about 63 from the 63 days from his 721 come and drink waypoint to his 24th day of the ninth month? I will shake the dual heavens and the earth waypoint. And he also says he's going to bless us in relation to the 24th day of the ninth month, which is day number 63. It's also day number 64 encompassing for today, but of course there's no draw today. Today's 64th day of the war. It's also day number 113 total of his man of the feast, counting from 6-1, but it's 114 for the Passover, encompassing the four man of the feast waypoints. Parallel in last night's bonus ball of four and other things as well with the four offspring and such. But 63 day of the war yesterday. Yesterday was day number 63 of the war. Day number one was on 490, the 490th Silver Trumpet Assembly. Say what? And it goes up last night from 43Z. To plus 20 to reset. It goes up from it goes down from, I guess it was a 497 plumb line. It goes down to a 43Z plus 20 plumb line to a 63Z plumb line. All these parallels. Yesterday was a 63 day of the war. Can you really make it up? But anyway, and I talked about 721 plus 63 is yesterday. Plus 63 is 924 yesterday. I'll shake the dual heavens of the earth. It's also the wine, the 50 becoming 20 press prophecy for the 24th day of the ninth month, and the 10 becoming 20 becoming 10 prophecy of yesterday's of the 924 waypoint. But anyway, day number one, and keep in mind the war was for the 490 silver trumpet assembly, tying these three sets of 490 that are at hand. So 43 zillion for tomorrow night's mega zillion plus six more thunders. That would be the first thunder plus six more thunders of 20Z each is 120 for raising me up to be king in association with 4 months or 120 days. Well, that's 120 plus 43 is 163. Yesterday was 163 days from 910. Can you really make it up? Could anybody do that? Come on, folks. You can't be that bitterly obstinate, are you? Yeah, you are. That's just crazy. So moving on along, I'm getting there. That's bitterly obstinate. That's amazing. I'm going to give you a couple review of a couple of those things. Two lowest balls last day, 411. Operation Grapes of Wrath, 16 days, started on 411, 1996. 16th reduction last night. Can you really make it up? What are the odds? Getting ready. He's really established. Yesterday's video is the joke's on you. Who's going to have the last laugh? I'm still laughing. He took 473.1 zillion out of the depository of his house last night, and I'm still laughing about it because first of all, it don't even matter. 20 is more than we need. It ain't about the amount of money. It's about, because he's going to bring all the gold and silver here anyway. Everything. Everything's his. So it's just what it is. So believe me, the laughs on you. However it's worded, but of course I'm not gonna be laughing. I'm gonna be inside really crying about it because it's so sad. But right now, before it happens, it's easy to mock you. That's just you're really that bitter opposite. Video yesterday, 41.10 for another 411 at the length. Can I really make that up? Okay. Oh, Isaac. Isaac, Sarah 90 years old, Abraham 100, 10 years difference. Sarah's really going to break forth the child? She laughed herself. She said, I didn't laugh, but yeah, she laughed. 1,014-day gestation? from Maher and Rachel? Oh yeah, give me a break. Go ahead, laugh all you want. 991-day gestation for the faithful witness of twins Uriah and Zachariah based on the process called superfetation. Yeah, right, right. 991 means belly, same as the same word as 990 for belly, womb. 1040 means house of the weaned or house of the rinsed. Okay, so you say, what? 1014-day gestation. Well, that's what he's done. I mean, first of all, the children were caught up. There was Maher and Rachel were miscarried three strokes. They had the two miscarriages in Montana with the elder wife that's fled in the wilderness. And Maher and Rachel, three strokes each. So that's six and plus eight. Plus Zachariah and Uriah were miscarried once. So that's 10 miscarriages. Three daughters and seven man-child, same as Job. Because this word's written upon me, and the story of Job, my affliction is written upon me too. And he even says that I've chosen that this affliction is in your stead, even in that when you look up the words, when Elihu's talking. Today was cartoon number 453 for Elihu. I like that because a whirlwind Yahweh spoke to Job out from a whirlwind, didn't he? And I'm speaking to you out from a whirlwind now, believe it or not, because that's because I'm gonna go put the umbrella. I'm gonna go put the umbrella over top of this this phone whenever to get it out of the sun when I go to upload this video. 490 day from the second dove. 1118 waypoint, which is day number 318, parallel when he spoke the 10 words out to her ancestor. And he spit the sign of the dove out of the belly 10 years ago today. 490 day from the second dove. Is today sign of the dove waypoint, 10th smooth stone anniversary. What are the odds? Oh, the wife's 910 days away from giving birth to these children? No, 910 days what she's been fled. She's 162 days away from giving birth to the children. Excuse me. 43 plus 120, 163 days. Yesterday when I did the video, when it went down to 20, when it went down from 473.1 to 20 zillion, was T minus 163 to 910. Can you really make it up? 910 on our Maker's Restored counters, the 250 year parallels, 250 minakora, and the $250 of the price of the dog and the price of the whore that talked about in other videos. Number 36 was drawn last night as well, along with the number 11. And then I told you about the other three. I told you about the 11 too. 411, 4 was the bonus ball. Number 36, Isaac was 36 years of age at the threshing floor of Ornan. What David paid 650 shekels for, 600 shekels of gold and 50 shekels of silver. 728 was the day the golden belt was made, plus 600 days. Not 728 a few years earlier, because it was several years earlier, but 728, the golden belt was made, plus 600 days. The gold of Uphaz, the belt, was made, plus 600 days. Is today's 328 waypoint? Can you really make it up? The sign of the dove waypoint? 608, the day Moses came down and found our ancestors playing the whore, plus 650 for those extra 50 shekels of silver is today. Okay, can you make it up? 608, which is day number 158, which is huge too. But 50 days ago would have been 208, which day 208 is 728. Double 728. Day number 208 is 728 is the day the golden belt was made. That's day number 208 of the year. Take away 50 from today, and that's 208. 208 is day number 38, but day number 208 is 728. The 650 both equal the day the golden belt was made. You really make it up from today. Strong's number 4,731 for last night's 473.1 zillion jackpot is used in 16 different verses. It's used 18 times, but for the 16 days of operation, it's 16 different verses. And it means staff, refers to Jacob's staff. It refers to the rods that he did for the flocks to have them be speckled and ring shake and stuff so they would become his flocks when they came to drink. But it's also his staff that he took with him when he left there and stuff. It also refers to the staff of the Passover. We have the staff in your hand for the 114 Passover instructions and for his backup Passover. David took this 4731 with him when he went to go and smite the 9-foot-9-inch uncircumcised Philistine. It's the staff of Jeremiah 111, which is huge as well. Even the 111 is huge in this, with the 111 days of justify with the triple crown. tying into tomorrow night's 288th draw total, but it's the 133rd Mega Millions. But it also is the two staffs of Zechariah chapter 11, which is, one of them's called the beauty and one of them's called the bands. And clearly, now you say in the early days, you thought the bands was Saul of Tarsus. My shoulder's hurting, sorry. But, and I did, but I got more understanding and I realized the bands is referring to me because precept upon precept. But, so in other words, I'm a 4731 that's in Arizona. And an Arizona resident hit the jackpot last night, the 4731 jackpot. Really? His bands is in Arizona, folks. It is what it is. Can you really make that up? Yesterday's video, I talked about 202 the day, the Groundhog Day waypoint, but 202 on our Maker's Restored calendars the day Solomon started building the first house he caused to build his name. I talked about yesterday in the video. 202 plus 55 is for the signature ring. Isaiah 55 was yesterday in the video. The first four balls last night drawn, meaning the 61, 62, 68, and the 11 totaled up to, no, yeah, and the 11 totaled up to 202. Oh yeah, you really make that. What part of yesterday's draw, last night's 473.1 zillion reduction to a person in Arizona when his bands are in Arizona, what with the staff, the 4731, two staffs, one of them's the beauty and one of them's the bands, the beauty being Yeshua. What part of last night's draw wasn't in yesterday's video? Ask that question. Well, not the part about talking, giving ear to the near kinswoman, which I suggest you do as she did. Sees with his anointed no matter what. But truly amazing, with the bonus ball of four for the four offspring, first four offspring, and the first four, the four spirits of wisdom, understanding, counsel, knowledge that he's sitting out through these four offspring, the first four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed. And of course, you got the three spirits of the, like frogs, three unclean spirits, and you got these for another three and four parallel. Today plus 3.5 days of the 7 days that are remaining, depends, I guess, if you count 7:34 p.m. tonight is the beginning or 7:34 a.m. tomorrow is the beginning. But, and I was thinking, because you have to count from today, but probably tomorrow, which would take us to, we would have 20, and we'd have then the 30, the first and the second a.m. So it's either going to be 7:34 a.m. on 4:02 or p.m., I would say. No, it would either be 7:34 p.m. on 4:01 or 7:34 a.m. on 4:02, I think. I got to look at it on paper. But regardless, these 3.5 days, because you'll be cutting with it, he keeps giving tier after tier after tier of those 7 days of him cutting through his anointed for 3.5 days for you to turn from your rebellion to him and stop stealing from him and come under the cover because the substitution sacrifice of this. But truly remarkable. Also, we're here to the Sabbath and the head of the month again, which means we're to Amos 8. Sabbath tomorrow, the head of the month days, follow the two head of the month days of with Jonathan and David. But Amos 8 says, when will the head of the month be over that we can buy and sell, and the Sabbath that we can put forth grain? Well, that's amazing. Amos 8 to A's hand again. But Pablo sent the man in California, one of those 3 men that's not stealing from Capeway, or has returned from not stealing from him. He said, what about the last Sabbath on 322, on the 321st Sabbath for that 321 prison mattress? But he said, and he didn't know it was the 321st Sabbath, I don't think, but he would put the prison mattress. But he said the 10 years in prison of revelations of his two sons, could that be, the 10 days in prison, could that be 10 years in prison? Wow. The dove, the set free bird with the Twitter purchase, the Twitter set free. Of course, I talked about the blasphemy of free speech and stuff, in the last video. But wow, that's amazing. 10 years in prison. And here, the sign of the dove was 10 years ago today. And I've been in the chief seat of scattered descendants of Israel for 10 years now today. Suppose I got spit out of the belly of a plane. I think it was early afternoon or so, mid-afternoon. So not quite 10 years yet. But 428, today on Satan's calendar, mirroring his feast of sevens, and all this parallel with sevens, because the count, two-part count, those 103 days, seven Sabbaths for the wave omer, plus 50 days, takes us to 428 on his restored calendar. And today's, so 717, 10. Today's day number 11 of those, of Moses' 40 days, so it would be day number 20 of the 50. Today, 2050. Wow, today's number to come to a wine press to uncover 50. There'll be 20 in the coming to wine vat to uncover 50. There'll be 20 in the press. Wow, but 20 have passed. 20 have passed here to with today's the 20th day. 20 will pass soon. But a big one for tomorrow is day number 65 of the year. For 65 days, a day for a year of is Isaiah chapter 7, Emmanuel, Manchal, Mahershala, Kuspag's prophecy. But I suggest that you give ear to the near kinswoman, like last night's draw testifies to, like Operation Grapes of Wrath testified to, because he tied last night's draw into Operation Grapes of Wrath big time. And he tied the vision that follows to followed it into the whirlwind of Elijah and the crossing the Jordan. And that's just reality in the steamboat and everything else. But he certainly did that. He certainly set up a good reason for you to laugh at his anointed a little further, didn't he? Kept afflicting me in your stead. But we are getting ready to find out who's going to have the last laugh.